The Stem Cell Translation Laboratory here at the National Center for Advancing Translational Sciences is intended to enable the amazing promise of induced pluripotent stem cell technology. These have enormous potential for treating untreatable diseases, for allowing us new ways to discover new drugs which could treat those diseases.
Induced pluripotent stem cells, or iPSCs, have the potential to generate all human body cell types. Scientists can use these linchpins of regenerative medicine to repair or to replace tissue or organ function lost due to birth defects, disease, injury, or aging.
To generate induced pluripotent stem cells, we first derive skin cells or blood cells from a healthy or diseased person. Then 4 defined genes are introduced into these cells. So these are OCT4, SOX2, KLF4, and CMYC. As a consequence, over the next 3 to 4 weeks, these cells then, such as blood cells, change their identity and get reprogrammed into these iPS cells. Once these cell lines are established, you can grow them indefinitely in the laboratory or differentiate them into any cell type of the human body. The differentiation process basically takes a primitive stem cell and turns it into specialized cells, such as blood cells, liver cells, heart cells, brain cells.
NCATS Stem Cell Translation Laboratory is supported through the NIH Common Fund's Regenerative Medicine Program. This state-of-the-art 4,400-square-foot facility is outfitted with the most cutting-edge research technologies. For example, to increase efficiencies, NCATS scientists use a robotic cell culture system that enables the standardized expansion of nearly 100 different stem cell lines in parallel. By using fully automated methods together with single-cell analysis, researchers can develop new, efficient protocols that can accelerate production and utilization of large numbers of specialized cell types, such as brain cells, liver cells, heart cells, and many others. Researchers at the Stem Cell Translation Laboratory also have access to various other NCATS resources. For instance, there's 3D bioprinting to generate new tissues and organs from stem cells. Another example is high-throughput robotic screening systems that enable more than 100,000 chemical, genetic, or biological tests in a single day. These tools may help scientists more quickly find solutions to public health epidemics, such as the opioid crisis.
The iPS cell technology is a very elegant approach because it uses the patient's own cells. So therefore, we wouldn't expect rejection by the immune system once these cells are given back to the patient to treat conditions such as Parkinson's, type 1 diabetes, or liver failure.
Patients with retinitis pigmentosa, which is a rare disorder, causes blindness, have a defect, a genetic defect, which leads the light-sensing cells in the back of the eye to die. And a promise of this technology is to take induced pluripotent stem cells from those patients, turn them into the kind of cells which are lost in this disease, and then delivering them back into the eye. If we can do that, those cells, because they come from the patient, they'll recognize, oh, I know what I'm supposed to do. I'm in the back of the eye. I'll make the connections that I need to make with the other cells in the eye and potentially restore sight to the blind.
Currently, the biggest impediment to widespread clinical use of iPSCs is the lack of highly reproducible, well-defined, and safe protocols that are required to differentiate iPSCs into specialized cells. NCATS is working to solve this translational science problem through strategic collaborations with public and private sector investigators across various research disciplines.
Through the Stem Cell Translation Laboratory, NCATS is improving health through smarter science.